Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. Blind, I am the RPG chick. Today is just going to be all research and development. Hope you guys don't mind overly much. I've been really neglecting that part of, well, everything. Under the request or the advice of Natalie, woo, shout out, I'm going to be crafting or developing the X5 Ghost as well as the Sandstorm, because why not? And the Sandstorm is actually every other quest we have, by the way, except for this Meridian, takes place in Elendon. So don't worry, we're gonna be getting into Elendon. Additional tasks, I believe it's the last one. Yeah, outlaw weapon crafting. So I'm going to make the Sandstorm, which is a assault rifle, I believe. But so I'm going to do both of those, and then we're going to see what we can do about armor. See how much left we have for that kind of stuff. But first, let's debrief and assign more strike team missions. Zulu 6, doing acquiring enemy research. Failure. Wah wah. Gather intel for the Echo team. Successful. Ta-ta-la. And punish killers for hotel team. Successful. Yay! Okay, so stuff. Research data. So this is good because we've got more research data that we can use. This is the claim all rewards. I haven't noticed that before, but I like to do them one by one. Remnant research data. Good. That's going to come in handy. M90 Indra. Don't know anything about that gun. We got some iridium. And some credits. Still wish it told you how many credits, but well. Well, so, 21 hours, 56 hours. So we have plenty of time to do that. Intercept enemy data. Yeah, we should be doing that. This expires really soon. Scout the unknown. Okay, so I'm going to put priority on this intercept enemy data. Intel says data on enemy combat plans is en route to a key adversary. Send a team to keep that data from reaching its target. Let's see, who should do this? 88%, 81%, 52%. Okay, not Zulu team. I'll have Echo team do this. In case, there's something even harder coming in. For the other team. When does this expire? 2 hours, right? This is 9.5 hours. Eliminate supply ships. We're tracking a few cargo ships ferrying supplies to enemy forces. Find those ships and take them out. And this is something good for Zulu team to do. 87% chance of success. Oh, here it says the hours. 1.74 hours. Let's hope for a win for Zulu team. That'd be good. And 21 hours, 56, 17, 13, 5 hours. Disrupt enemy movements. It was one of them what we weren't going to do because it was so difficult. And it's this one. So how about the 9 hours one? Doing that now. Wait. Oh, did I already? I chose that one already. Okay. One of these 13s. Scout the unknown. Silent but deadly. Silver credit loot box, okay. So... Wasn't there another 13 or just 17? Alright, I guess 17. It's silver, that's why... Oh, this is a 13 year. I see that. Okay, so this is... Gold item loot box. Protect embedded informant. Oh god. 29% chance of success. Never mind, we'll take the silver. Scout the unknown. Sensor detected a potentially valuable new area. Assemble a discovery team and dispatch them to investigate. Idiot percent chance of success. Okay. So we're all set with our new missions. Our new teams, rather. Can I recruit another team? Insufficient funds. I need 120 mission funds. And I have 85. Okay. Something to look forward to. Oh, 3 out of 6. Okay. I can have 3 more teams. Alright, so let's check out this. Oh, we got 16 credits, 40 credits. Research data unknown. Collect all rewards. 100 Milky Way research data. Minerals. Consumables. Biominerals. Tech materials. And credits. Yay! Is it boom? Oh, these things run out? Oh no, they're not running out. They're gonna give me rewards soon. Okay. More research points. Hmm. Out of 26 perks unlocked. I can't do anything. Okay, so now. Get into this. Research center. Okay, so it's research first, with the research data turns into a thing, and then you can develop that thing. So I want to take the Sandstorm. Requires one. So you have to do them one at a time. So this uses up your research data. Of course. The blueprint will be added to development branch of the research and development terminal. You can launch the development once you've gathered all the required resources. So that's the cost, and that's how much we have. Now I think that flips. I think originally all this explanation wasn't in there. I think they added that with a patch. Not completely sure. Okay, so we've crafted that and we can, yeah, we have to do each one in succession, unfortunately. Sandstorm, it's all right. 3. Just checking, I guess each one is going to require the one before it. So that's everything. Oh! Advanced Sandstorm Assault Rifle. Okay. A highly accurate rifle, the Sandstorm was developed by exiles from the Nexus after their arrival in Helios. The design of the semi-automatic weapon has been streamlined and appears to adapt certain non-initiative technologies. Alright, so the advanced. We can craft this one now. Let's research. Oh, we still got so many. So much research data, so. Continue. We got that one. Oh, we got this one. We have to be level 60. We are level 50. Alright. So we're not doing that one yet. So we're going to stop at Sandstorm Assault Rifle 7. And this, I'm really just doing this for the quest. I'd like to compare it with the X5 Ghost. We really have used not that much of our research data, so we should be able to, you know, I'm thinking get the Ghost up to 7 possibly as well. So these are details. Four augmentation slots. Okay. Okay. Development. Okay. So we can just ignore all this crap, I believe, and just go right to the 7. Because why should we mess with the lower ones, right? Select. Okay. Anti-armor module. Okay. Power damage bonus. Beam emitter. Okay. I have, like, looked up some facts about this stuff. The beam emitter... See, it doesn't even tell you here. It tells you weapon stability plus 200 will override any fire type augment. So it fires, from what I can understand, different from then on. Now fires a sustained energy beam that accurately deals rapid damage to the target. I heard it is less damage. Like, very much less damage. I don't know, like, it really does a lot less damage. I wish I could give you a number, but... So I'm gonna opt out of the beam emitter. Too bad. Ultra rare. I don't even know when or where I got it. Biotic damage booster. Recharge. Combat power. Still it's power. Combat recharge. This is all powers. Duration boost. Kinetic coil. Okay, that one does extra weapon damage. And from what I only have one of these. From what I understand, these all stack. So if you have 4 kinetic coils, you can put 4 kinetic coils and you'll be doing plus 12% weapon damage. So, pretty sweet. But I only have one. Mod slot extension, plus 1 mod slot. I have 2 of those. I'm gonna use one on the... I'm gonna use one on the X5 Ghost. I'm betting that I'm gonna be using that one. Newtonian... What is this? Bonus to 1 or more stats... Oh, power force. So this really, ironically, on your weapon, but so much boosts to your powers, which is not used with the weapon, so it's kind of weird. Combos, yeah. Not going to be using that. I don't combo that often. When I do, it's cool, so rebalance field coils. For the last 20% of the clip's ammo, gain 10% extra damage. Okay. And these other things are if you put it on your armor. So I have 3 of those. That's pretty sweet. I'll probably use that then. Shield bypass. Okay. Power damage bonus to shields. Not ammo. Not your gun. So support power module. Again, power. Tech recharge module. I mean, I might as well use some of this crap. I only have 1 kinetic coil, so... What was this thing I was using? Oh, yeah. So this will be sweet in case I do end up using this, right? So I've got the... that on there, and... So as long as you have the gun... selected, right? Well, you can only carry 1 assault rifle anyway, so it doesn't... But, from what I heard, you... I'm not completely sure if it was right. It was like people seem to be guessing at it. But if you have your gun, and then... your melee weapon. It, like, stacks. Like, whatever melee weapon you have with you, even though if you're not using it, and then whatever gun, if you have it selected, like if it's the current gun used in your loadout kind of thing. Doesn't stack with all the guns, in other words. So, duration boost. Plus 5%, 5%, 5%. This thing. Power damage to armor. Well, this is +5% power to anything. Not just armor. Not just shields, so I'll take that. So even though I'm not doing anything this episode, just working on this, it's going to take me a while. Support power module. Power restoration and defense. Now these are for tech abilities, which I don't even use. Shield bypass. That's for shields. Combo, no. Combo. +5% power force. I only have one. I think I already know what I'm putting on the X5. Duration boost. Combat recharge. +5% to combat recharge speed. Fine, I'll take this. And one more. One more. I have three of those. Okay. Craft. Sandstorm Assault Rifle. 7. I'm not going to change the name around. You can change the name to anything you want, obviously. I'm just going to change the AR, so... If it was my own playthrough, I'd pick like a goofy name or maybe something meaningful or something, but it's so you guys know what it is. If I rename it, you guys would be like, oh, what's the dookie butt gun? What is that? And I'd be like, I don't remember. So, thank you. Okay, so we have that. That's cool. Consider that developed, and now X5 Ghost. Andromeda Initiative engineers developed the automatic X5 Ghost from the baseline M8 Avenger to make it easier to maintain and modify aboard the Arx and the Nexus. The standard rifle for Initiative personnel also possesses recording and sensor functions so it can be left behind as a black box by doomed explorers. That last part, I can't imagine that that's a gameplay element, but yeah. Cool. It shows you how much you've put into each one. Up to 7 or 2 in the advance. Okay. So X5 Ghost. This is actually the weapon I've been told was used in the cutscenes of the game. And people were like, well, how can I actually use the gun used in some of the cutscenes, and well, okay. They added it in one of the updates. So, requirements, I gotta research everyone. Three requires 4, yep. Just checking in case you can skip one and it doesn't look like you can. Okay, is there an advanced? Yes, there is. Down to just over 3,000 Milky Way research data. Seven? Again, 8 requires level 60. Takes a little while to get there, so... Rather than put my points in and have to wait 10 levels, I'll just Save it. Okay, so I got 7. Now we can develop this. Bloop. These are stats, so we only get 3 augmentations here. I'm gonna put the kinetic coil on this one. On, what do you call it? I forget the name of the planet. With the trade post, Kadara. There is a kiosk somewhere, I believe, that sells these augmentations and or mods, so you can get more kinetic coils. But for now, I'm going to just add some other stuff here. I'm not going to ruin it with the beam emitter. I'd like to check out the beam emitter, but maybe. Guess not. Anti-armor. Very specific to biotic damage. Oh, we have that thing. Add a mod slot. Rebalance field coils, okay. That. And then I'm gonna do the add mod slot extension. Craft. X5 ghost. I don't know why I want to put AR, so... Everyone knows this is an assault rifle? I don't know. Ta-da! Okay. So this is if you want to make more of them, I guess, with different augmentations. So I've completed that craft, outlaw weapon crafting. Yes, I know about all of them. So... Oh, it's not even... This is allies and relationships. Additional tasks. So it's gone. Just making sure that we're not supposed to craft anything else. I do want to go around, run around, and make, like... I don't know. Some episodes doing these things. And it would basically be, like... like a montage, because I'll cut out all the journeying in between. I'm just like showing the map. Okay, I'm here, and here's this cat device, etc. So now, check out our new weapons here. Yeah, this has nothing on it. This is my pistol, right? Okay. Now these are mod slots, right? Right. Okay. So... can you see here what... Right, okay. You can see. Plus one mod, so originally only 2 mod slots then? That's harsh. Oh yeah, 2 like that. Okay. Alright, so these will stack as well, as far as I understand. So, okay, AR stuff. Okay. Heavy stock. That's really good. 105% assault rifle stability. Sold. Oh, I'm putting that on the Sandstorm? I thought I had the Ghost on here. How do I empty this? Just choose something else. Yeah, put that there. Cause I wanna deal with the other one. We're doing ghost right now. Okay. A little cumbersome, I think we can figure it out though. So penetration damage, clip size, stability. I want that on there. Am I choosing that? What? Wait. Okay, finally I'm getting it on the right one. I guess I kept selecting the other one. I don't know. That one? Yes, I'm gonna make sure I have... Get out of that. Okay. Ghost. Alright, what else do we want to put on ghost? Rifle clip size. I'm not sure if this stacks together. Well, it's already on it, right? Let's go. See, it puts me back in Sandstorm. That's like driving me insane. This is checked because it's on the other weapon. Got it, okay. AR light. Assault rifle clip. Assault rifle clip size. I mean, that can't hurt, that's for sure. Accuracy, that's just a lower... Well, that says heavy stock. And that says recon scope. I guess we got two different accuracy things going on. Somehow I doubt, yeah. That's gonna override the other accuracy things, so... Long barrel, okay. So I could choose long barrel for damage and then change the clip size to counterman that. Long barrel, yeah. Why does he keep doing that? If I put it on the... Why is it... This is driving me insane. I don't know how to remove it, so I'm just putting another one there. Now, you hear... I have this selected here. I click that. Why? Why is it putting on the other? Do I have to do that? Maybe that's what I have to do. No. I'm in the ghost. Ghost. It keeps putting me back to Sandstorm. Why are you doing that? Ghost, damn you. Why? I don't understand this, guys. I'm not sure if this is me, or what am I doing wrong here? Now I just really want to get rid of this so it stops putting it on there. Maybe I can't do it when it's equipped? Or maybe because I'm in the equip menu. No. Alright. You're driving me to drastic measures now. I'm selling the goddamn Sandstorm. Jesus. I don't know how to stop the mods from going onto that one. So I'm just gonna sell the damn thing. Sorry guys, this is frustrating as hell. Let's sell the salvage while we're at it. Thank you very much. The mod should be off of this one. Details. Too bad, then I wasted that thing. My gain is zero. Oh, my gain is 566. I don't know how to stop this from happening, so... I will remove it from my... Wait. It's still here. I sold the other one? Sell the Sandstorm. Sell the goddamn thing. What? Why the Sandstorm 6? I guess that's the one I sold. Okay. I thought I sold my X5 Ghost by mistake. Just gonna check and make sure I did not do that. No, here it is. Okay, now, damn it. Oh, it's going right to that. What are we in? What gun are we in here? What is this? X5 Ghost. Okay, now it's working. I don't know what major malfunction was. Now I want something that gives you more clip size because this... I want to see what that is. Stability. -12% assault rifle clip size. Okay. So, this one, we will increase the clip size. +52%. Done. Cool. Alright, so I basically did the other one just to finish the quest, which is fine. It's really stupid that it wouldn't let me... I can sell one of these Zulkins as well. Now, I know I have the pistol. Maybe I should just... Can I even research that one? With the phalanx or whatever? Let me sell this extra Zalk in here. I got two. Is that open? Yep. Alright. So... I want to look at M25 Hornet. Well, I can't see what I have currently using. So, let me just take a look here. I think it's Phalanx? Sorry guys, just bear with me here if you want. M5 Phalanx 4. M5 Phalanx 4. So let's see if I can research any more M5 Phalanx. And then... we were in shotguns, pistols. Well, these in no particular order. Oh, I guess we can't research that? I'm missing something? Cyclone, Charger, Ruzad, Sandstorms, Sidewinder, Vanquisher. Now, I heard there are other good weapons, so... Oh! Not only that, but you can go Helios technology, which, yeah. I really do like the Thoken. There's a Thoken. Sudden death. So I don't know, I might mess with the Thoken. People were saying the Thoken was rather good as well, so. I agree, I just have an older model, because I had 4, right? Now I'm using 7, up to 7 with what do you call it? Electric Ferran. I went to 7 with the X5 Ghost. Alright, so... and Remnant technology. I heard the Paw was really good too. Fires a continuous, high-energy particle beam with incredible accuracy, particle accelerator weapon. For short-term operations, its power supply is effectively inexhaustible, and overheating is the only concern. The PAW combines Remnant particle beam technology and Andromeda initiative targeting and stabilizers. Theoretically, it may be scalable to a ship-sized version. Theoretically, huh? Well, okay. So I'm still not seeing any of my... I still don't see the M5 Phalanx. So that, I believe, we go back to original Mass Effect in such that the weapons overheat rather than you run out of ammo. Which is cool, too. Alright, so it looks like, at least, I don't think... you can research this at all. That's a pistol. So, I might just keep my pistol as it is, for now, anyway. Because I might want to do some research on what might be the best pistol. So, let's look for armor. They've got the Hyper Guardians, they've got the N7s. And really, that's it for Milky Way. And then... oh, you can also research augmentations? What? Oh, that's pretty neat. Well, this would require a little more forethought than I gave it. Grenade launcher? Sweet. Non-shotgun weapons. -10 weapon recharge rate. Stick your grenade. Rebalanced field coils. This is the one we have. Vintage heat sink. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. This is the one that also turns you into original Mass Effect. Ammo refills automatically after a delay, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong, but... Plus 5% damage bonus when moving slowly with a drawn weapon. Move faster and you get more. Alright. Well, the next gun I might put a grenade launcher. That's pretty cool. Alright, so anyway, armor for Helios Technology. Ingaran Gorilla, Cat Fusion, Helios Defender. Is there more? No. That's sweet looking. I like the look of that. Also, it all comes in one part. So it's not separated into legs and chest and arms. What I really heard is the coolest one, or the most... The Remnant Heritage. Which is really expensive to get. Let me just check it out. This armor was designed from scratch by the Initiative using Remnant technology. Its servos, microframe computer, and kinetic barrier generators are all dependent on Remnant science and artifacts. This resilient and regenerative hard suit has an energy surplus, though its internal systems can be difficult to properly monitor. Now these, I heard, is the best with the shield and the health regeneration and damage resistance. There are other armors, which, you know, are good if you're using powers or tech, and this, but this is the most, like, as far as not being killed. So how much does this require? Oh, we need Remnant polymer for this? Oh, this is the actual research data. Okay. Alright. So there's all these stats, and it has 5 slots to put stuff in. So yeah, I'm gonna be dumping points into this. I don't know how high I should go. I don't know how high I can go. The chest is probably gonna be the most expensive part with everything. I have 5. It's a good thing I have a lot of research data. Okay, so now we got advanced Remnant Heritage chest. Look how high this goes up. Plus 11 damage resistance, plus 13% health and shield regeneration, and plus 32 health and shield regeneration delay reduction. So it's a third less delayed, I'm thinking. Starting to get a little costly. And I'm guessing this one, level 60. So you might as well go to 7. At least with the chest. I'm not going to be able to do all of them, I'm pretty sure. So before I even screw around with this, even more, let's see if I can even craft this. If I have all the... Remnant Heritage Chest 7. So I'm thinking, this is a little misleading, what I'm thinking is that it requires 60, and I have 2431. It requires 260, I have 2099, I think that's what it is. What about... Yeah, I can't put that on a... Nope. That's what I thought. Well, it makes sense. The grenade only for, what do you call it? Weapons. Chest. Stuns melee attackers with electrical damage. Cool. Any more chest things? Increases weapon accuracy by 10% when standing still. That's good, because I'm usually standing still. And in cover. So that's good. Rebalance field coils. It's checked, though, which means that I already researched it. Rebalance field coils. I'm not sure what else I want to put on that. Actually, augmentations are in the three different slots as well. Keep forgetting that. Ricochet system. Each projectile bounces off of flat surfaces. Projectiles now travel in a ballistic arc. That's to a gun. Coolant unit. These are all guns. It's not specifying. I guess I can use that on anything. Plus 10% weapon. Gun. Battlefield assist module. When health is 20% or lowered, plus 25 resistance to all damage. I like that. Battlefield assist. I'm going to look at these, though. There's the beam emitter. Cryo condenser. Put on legs. Extra 50% cold damage. Oh, on jump melee. Shield disruptor. Jump melee. I don't jump melee, really. On enemy killed, restore 25% shields. That's pretty sweet. I like that. Shield sensors. 25% chance to recover 10% of health when shields are broken. Power booster. Power booster. Okay, so I got shield oscillator. And I want to put... battlefield assist. ...20% or lower. Okay, resistance damage. The other one's shields. Okay, good. Oh, that takes out of Helios research data. So I can research all this crap. Why not? What am I using it for? Maybe more Helios stuff pops up. Okay. I just researched all the augmentations. Now this we want to save. Remnant, because we're going to use that for our armor. We're gonna be running out as it is, so. And the Milky Way, I'll hold on to that as well. Can use that for X5 Ghost to upgrade whenever we get to level 60. Actually, no. I'm gonna go back. No, actually. Sorry, guys. This is a long episode, wow. So this is completely optional, of course. Okay, so we got the craft, put our augmentations. I want a battlefield assist. For chest. Weapon, gear. 2%, really small. I mean, so what? So what? I mean, if I run out of stuff, I'll end up using it. Oh, it's 2%, 2%. What was the other one I made? Okay, click on that. I got all these dinky little ones. Where's the other one I made for the chest? Where's the shield oscillator? I made that. I researched that. Do I need to go into... Wait, okay. I have to go into development and develop it as well, don't I? Special items. It's not special items. Nomad. Armor. Oh, it's under ready to develop. It's under here? Oh. Alright. Oh, and I have this stuff. 458 melee damage? Oh. I can't just... It's all mixed in here. Alright. I'm gonna sell all this armor. You're kidding me, all this crap? And I can't filter out? Biotic Amplifier 5. This must be other stuff I picked up. I wonder if... The stuff would be at the bottom. So they just made it? No. It's all mixed in. Damn it. Torque. Oh, that's for... Oh, this is hell here with all this stuff to develop. It's all mixed in. That's for the Nomad. I have a Paw Assault Rifle 1 ready to develop. Omniblade. Oh, Emergency shield discharge. Oh, that's for the Nomad. Cybernetic device. Oh, that's a special item. So we've got... helmet, chest, arms, legs. The stuff wouldn't be... No, this is all just chest stuff. I figured they might just throw the... because this is everything. That's like everything. I don't want everything. Wait, here's some stuff with... I'm trying to sneak up on it because the thing goes away. Heritage chest... Too many! Botic amplifier. What does it look like? It's... Well, it's in alphabetical order, right? So, rebalanced field coils. I don't write this crap down. Rebalanced field coils, right? Yeah, I don't want that beam of electricity. I can just find it alphabetically. Battlefield assist module, right? For chest. I put one of them on already. I gotta go check what that is. I did all this. Just, I don't know, blue plasma bolts. Yeah, I don't think I want to use any of this stuff. And then I chose one here. Shield oscillator. So I'm going to use all those, and I'll just fill the other ones with those crappy little ones that we have. So, development. Wait. It's not in order. What do we have on here now? Wait. Ready to develop. I gotta develop first. You know, it looks here. It is in alphabetical order and it's sectioned out, I think. So should put them all together? No, it isn't. Alright, never mind. I got the Biotic Amplifier. There's gotta be a better way for this. I can't just look at everything that's ready to develop, which is... an augmentation? So I'm not seeing any of the ones that I... Just clearing that. Alright. Viper Sniper. He's your Viper Sniper. See, it's not in order. I hate that. I really hate that. I'm getting a pain in my foot. Okay. Well, I know I'm passing the thing by. I guess whatever doesn't have augmentations is an easy way to see it. Agility mode. And materials required. I'm not seeing it. Oh, this is driving me insane. Why wouldn't it be here? Maybe I don't have to develop them? Because I put the money into them. I want to put it on my gun now. On my chest, rather. Remnant Heritage Chest 7. Oh, that's my battlefield assist. Well, do I already have that on there? Oh, I think I exited out. Alright, so battlefield assist. Maybe I'd have to go out and back in. I'm hoping. What's the other one? Rebalanced field coils. It's not in there. Rebalance is not in there. Battlefield assist. Good. The other one is shield. Shield oscillator? Shield... No, it's not this one. Why aren't you there? I want you there. I put the money into it. Where is it? Unless those are mods? It says they're augmentations, though. That's driving me insane. Where are my augmentations? Unless you can't put that on. You can only put certain things on Remnant. I mean, that is pretty sweet, but I have four more slots here. And besides, it does let me put regular stuff on here. I have battlefield. Maybe I have to do something else in the process. This drives me crazy. This really is just driving me crazy. What's not found here? That one. Thank you. Oh, something else. Because I did all these. That one. Whoop. And that one. Okay, what's the other thing? Rebalanced field coils. I made it. Where is it? Rebalanced field coils. Battlefield assist is there. And that's Helios. And the other is Remnant. Shield oscillator. Shield oscillator. Yeah. Oscillator. Couldn't even read my own handwriting. Maybe completely exit out? I don't know. Where is it? Emergency shield discharges. That's for that. Biotic amplifier. Put that there. There's all rifles, chest, pistol, legs, helmet, chest, arms. I'm just looking at augmentations. If it changes to where it says just materials, then it itself is an augmentation. Or maybe even a mod, I don't know. Maybe those are mods? They're on the bottom. You got me, man. All right, I don't know what to do, so I'm just gonna put the battlefield thing on there. Pretty sweet. Too bad I can't find anything else. Everything else is 2%. Weak. Alright, 2% biotic power damage. I gotta figure out what's going on with this. 2% recharge speed. I mean, I'm not even gonna notice the difference with this crap. Combat recharge speed. Doesn't really matter. 2% power force. Remnant Reborn armor? Oh. Done. Huh. Okay. Cool. So, now I can try to... Oh, not weapons. New. Armor. Helmet. So I start with this. 2% damage resistance, health regeneration, shield regeneration. Okay. I'm not gonna be able to make it that far. I might just have different arms and legs for now. And that's the other only other thing, right? Is the arms and legs? Yeah, arms, legs, helmet, chest. So now we're up to, yeah, pretty good shield regen there. How far can we go? We can probably go to 7 with this. As long as I have the materials, right? Okay, so now we have advanced Remnant Heritage helmet. This isn't as nearly as costly as a chest. That's good. I might be able to actually research all these. This one's... that requires 60. So I'm gonna stop here with that. Done! So into development. We go. Just clearing out the exclamation marks. Okay. Heritage helmet. 7. Thank you stuff. Now this should all stack too, shield regeneration stuff. I know there's other augmentations for helmet and stuff I should look into, but I couldn't get everything added anyway. So I got the helmet. Now back out. Yeah, arms. See how far we can get. Let's see if I can do legs up to 5. I might be using old legs. It's only 175. So these will be a little behind. Okay. So I'm gonna have 5 arms and 3 legs. We gotta find ourselves some more remnant research data, don't we? Want some anti-armor, why not? And shields? Or shield bypass? Yeah. Craft. Okay, so we got legs 3. Crafted. And then out. Let's... I thought I cleared that one. Okay, arms. clearing out these. Okay. We went up to 5 with the arms. 2% melt. It's not useful at all. Hardly at all. Is health. Combo. I hardly ever do combos. Shield accelerator. Shield booster. Combat power. Done. Okay, then we can put all this crap on. Hour 21. Just wanted to check that. Can I get anything else from here? Some stuff was gonna unlock soon, right? Forty-two minutes. All right. I could just sit around and do nothing, and wait for the stuff to deliver, right? But nah. So, it's not loadout, right? There's nothing in here. Is it loadout where I put choose the armor? I do, okay. Okay, so I'm going for Pathfinder Scout Armor 3. Where is it? Oh, Remnant. Why didn't I see it? Remnant Reborn Armor. Sweet. And I have this Maverick. Oh, I can put a mod on this. Fusion mod of rapid deployment. Plus 50% all power recharge speeds. But unfortunately, minus 30% weapon damage. I don't like that. 20% damage resistance. Ugh. These mods are horrible. I'm not going to use any mods right now for that. Remnant Reborn Helmet. Cool. Can't put a mod on that, can we? Alright. Heritage Armor 3. And the arms. Remnant Heritage Armor 5. There we go. Confirm. So I just wanted to look at something. Can I see, like, the combined of everything here? Or does it not work that way? Guess it doesn't work that way. I mean, you can see it individually. Okay. Sweet. Liking it. We're gonna kick some butt now. With all this new stuff. So, wow, we've been going for well over an hour. So I'm gonna tune out here. I'm gonna buy and sell some stuff. And off screen, of course, and that's about it. So stay tuned next time for at least somewhat shorter episode of Mass Effect Andromeda. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and enduring. Grow strong.